over the Potsdam Bears.
Yeah, and with last night's game, Fredonia blew a 3-0 lead. They were up 3-0 early in the second period. Potsdam clawed their way back. And get it, Bears are clawed.
Ah!
And they tied it up 3-3. And like you said, Jared, Victor Tracy scored that goal with 2:41 remaining. And the Blue Devils were able to hang on to the victory. And that's something that we haven't been able to see them do lately. You mentioned the Buff State game. They gave up the goal with 5 seconds left. And that game went into overtime, but last night they hung on, and more importantly, they secured a spot in the SUNYAC playoffs.
SUNYAC standings, as Fredonia and Brockport now sit tied for 14, the 5th and 6th seeds. Plattsburgh's ahead by 1 at 15. This is, for all intents and purposes, the do-or-die game when it comes to who you're facing in the playoffs. Fredonia has it right now. You pop open that program for me. Bring me this. Fredonia right now sitting at the 5th seed. They will play the 4th, which as of right now would be Plattsburgh, but should they bump down that, it switches them. But they would, all intents and purposes, still play Plattsburgh.
And taking a quick look at what the standings are, Geneseo's in first with 23 points.
Oh, no. I misread this. Fredonia would jump ahead. They would be in the 3-4 bracket, which they would most likely in turn play Buff State.
Yeah, so Geneseo's first with 23. Oswego second with 20. Buff State third with 16. Plattsburgh fourth with 15. And then Fredonia and Brockport are tied for 5th with 14 each. So seeds 3-6 are—it's all up for grabs right now. They're all separated within 2 points, and these 3 games are huge because Fredonia can get a home playoff game and be a 3 seed instead of being a 6 seed and playing Geneseo.
Geneseo is a tough opponent, as we saw. You turn on over to the Fredonia schedule if you have it up. Take a look at the last time Geneseo was facing Fredonia, which was not too far long ago. Geneseo, Fredonia, over the winter break, it was January 18th, a 1-3 loss. And then go all the way back, which we had the 1-6 loss. Geneseo certainly a tough opponent to face. Fredonia wants a comfortable first round opponent, most likely. But nonetheless, we are here for the rink now. At long last, it is here. The Blue Devils were wearing white jerseys with pink and blue trim. Great taste for this year. Going over the starting lineup for Fredonia, or for Plattsburgh. Ian Walgren and Matt Arroyo will be at the defense. Pat Egan, this will be the second line coming out for the Cardinals. Cam Owens at center, number 19. And Cole Stallard over on the right wing, number 20. Jimmy Pareda out of Tonawanda, New York, number 29. Moving over onto the Fredonia side of things.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's this evening's starting lineup for your Fredonia Blue Devils.
Excited crowd here for Fredonia today.
The
top line on defense, number 5, at left, Charlie Manley. Max Blitz. On right. The fourth line coming up for Fredonia. Number 7, Todd Schaus, starts at left wing. Jasper Corkin-Barley at center, number 10. And number 20, three, Luke Rivera. On right wing. And after last night's performance, Eric Berger is back in net, the senior. We'll get more on you here after this break for the national anthems. We'll be back here on Hockey Night in Fredonia. Hockey Night in Fredonia is, of course, coming at you on WCBF 88.9 The Voice, WDVR 89.5 The Inferno, WNYF Television and YouTube Live. Head on up to the search bar, type in WNYF TV. That's right there on the top of the video's feed on the YouTube channel. Over here we got FredoniaAthletics.com Boxcast. The stream coming at you in perfect for Max Fredonia here, off an excellent night. Eric Berger, tonight's starting goaltender, also got action last night and had a stellar outing.
Yeah, Berger was great last night. He only allowed one goal. And, he's a senior and he's playing exceptionally well this year, and it's good to see him between the pipes again. And once again, this is Pink the Rink night, so 13th. Renewal of the Pink the Rink game, which began as a class project in 2007 to promote breast cancer awareness. And starting in 2008, people wishing to honor a loved one have been able to purchase and personalize the jerseys worn by all the Blue Devil players, resulting in a total donation of almost $84,000 to the American Cancer Society.
Impressive. Fredonia, of course, as I mentioned, in these very tasteful looking white, blue and pink uniforms. Blue, white, pink stripes with blue trim. The Plattsburgh Cardinals wearing their red away uniforms. Fredonia going right to left across your radio dial as we get started from Steele Hall.
This is always a special night, you know, for all the reasons behind this game with the promotion of cancer and raising the money for it, but especially tonight, in such a crucial SUNYAC matchup, this game is just amplified that much more. And, you know, we have a great crowd on hand tonight. Everyone's wearing pink. And, you know, it's got a certain feel to this game.
A great start for Fredonia, getting a couple quick shots off. There is Jimmy Morgan making his way up ice, down behind the net of Jimmy Perota. The Cardinals find the puck going down along the inside boards, but Fredonia is able to keep it. Owens, number 19 for the Cardinals, snakes his way up ice across the center dot, finds his way on the inside circle, makes a quick shot on Bogart. Cardinals circle around back again. It gets tipped up out of net. Jacob Engvall
Well, Jarrett, there's good news and bad news for us. The good news is Plattsburgh has names on the backs of their jerseys.
Sure,
and Fredonia has names, but they're not the actual names of the players.
It's the name of the donation, I believe.
Yeah,
made
that is,
in
that is
Florida. Thank you for the confirmations. Fredonia makes their way up ice. Number 20, Mike Freeman, trying to make something happen with it. However, it's Plattsburgh who gets the shot on net. Eric Bogart wouldn't get the glove on it. Fortunate turnaround at the blue line.
Already just over a minute into the period, and tempers are really flaring up between both teams. They both know this is a very crucial game because this game could set like a great tone of pace for the playoffs to come.
So we saw certainly some physicality last night, especially after the final horn
in the stands.
Tempers flared on and off the ice.
Yeah.
As we find our way back into this game, off the top of the corner, that's Todd Schaus dipping it towards center ice. Has to double back for Max Britz. Gives that one back for Schaus. Makes his way up ice. Luke Rivera with the hard shot. Gets deflected way up, back into the top of the protective netting.
Taking a look at the Cardinals' leading scorers so far, Rich McCartney, Pat Egan, Cam Owens, Matt Arroyo, they all have 11 points, and Ryan Kuhn has 10. So Plattsburgh is a very balanced scoring team.
Off the draw, the Plattsburgh Cardinals come away with it. Dunked in all the way on the inside circle. Fredonia collects the loose puck in their own zone. Goes two on three away with it. The second chance dumping at Bobby Polichuk. Moved away, coming down ice. A shot in, Bogart, not looking, but he makes the save regardless. Another shot, far in from the blue line, number 55, Ian Walden. The 6'2" right defenseman. Just one of several towering hockey players that these Cardinals have brought to the game tonight.
It's a team of giants. For certain.
Two defensemen. One's a senior, one, and the other one's a freshman. The senior is 6'7", that's Jacob Engvall, and the freshman is 6'6", Ian Walgren. So a lot of size to this Plattsburgh team.
Size that Fredonia has always been willing to get physical against. Philip Middleton goes on the inside blue line, tries to move the puck forward for his Cardinals teammate. Fredonia's able to bounce that one back. Tommy Martin chasing at the blue line, finds possession, moves up ice. Jacob Haynes steps it all the way past, down just inside of the red line for an icing.
Then for the Fredonia leading scorers, you just mentioned Jacob Haynes. He leads away with 18 points, 7 goals, 11 assists. Victor Tracy with his 9th goal last night, he now has 17 points. Luke Rivera and Charlie Manley have 14, and then Jimmy Morgan and Ethan Kurbis have 13.
Off the draw, Tommy Martin loses an edge. Potsdam's able to gain possession. On the inside circle, moving up ice, Morgan finds Haynes trying to get that one up past the circle. On the inside, Bayasulo looking for it. Haynes hunts around behind the net. Can't make it. Dips all the way back around Rich McCartney. Playing catch up on the boards there. Jacob Engvall tips that one all the way back towards the Fredonia zone. Stollard gets in a collision there with Ryan Rosenberg at center ice. The Cardinals have possession, moving back out of their zone after a recollect. A shot in, number 20, Cole Stollard. Bogart makes the save.
Brett Crandall, congratulations, Brett. You and two of your friends can enjoy Peanuts Pizza sitting on the Blue Devils couch. Once again, congratulations, Brett.
So it looks like we finally figured out who gets to sit on the couch. It is a P-Dubs promotion, which is interesting. How do I get into that? For the blue line. off the far circle, going for a tumble there. Number 19, Cam Owens on the Plattsburgh roster. He was able to find his way back, though. That's Plattsburgh hunting for a shot on net. Circling all the way behind was Egan. Rosen picked up. They're trying to put him in. They score. Finding the open net, number 16, Pat Egan. The Cardinal were up 1-0 early.
That was just a sloppy puck play from the Blue Devils. So he turned that one over, an errant pass resulted in a 2-on-1 for the Cardinals, and they find themselves up 1-0 early on in this game.
Very unfortunate.
Plattsburgh goal scorer number 16, Pat Egan.
Egan with the goal. Chris Starrett with the assist on that goal as play is back underway. Oh, Bogart makes a quick stop. So we reset for a faceoff coming to Eric's right. Fredonia wins the draw, but Cardinals will find the puck. Hunting around behind the net, number 22, Jesse Beer. He's on the inside corner. There's Middleton losing the edge as Fredoni goes away with it. Here comes Luke Rivera going cross ice for Todd Schaus with an interesting pass. Can't get much further as Plattsburgh stifles that play. Tom Bowie getting in the way of things as Plattsburgh finds possession in their own zones. Sloan moves it up ice for the Cardinals. Ross Sloan winds up out in Bogart's net. Now skating away is Middleton. Take the time here to mention that Bogart off a 35-save effort last night. A stellar performance despite the shaky lead handling. But in off the draw, Jacob Haynes trying to move that one out past the red line. It's seized up at the Fredonia door to their bench. Cardinals and the Blue Devils go back and forth with it as it's tipped all the way into the far corner. Engvall in behind the net. Fredonia will find possession of it. Tipping around by a zero. Out there with Brandon Spagnardi. Biasulo charged up on the boards. In the inside corner, Fredonia has the chance out in the open net, but Greg Malafoye with a nice move to get in the way of that play. Fredonia loses the edge as Plattsburgh advances it down the ice. Brandon Spagnardi cleans up for the icing call.
Well, this game, there are two of the longest tenured coaches around, with Jeff Meredith and Bob Emery, both 30 seasons with each of their schools.
Amazing. You can look right behind us and see Jeff Meredith back in 1994.
Yeah.
The fresh, smiling face of a man who will have a long and prosperous career here at the Fredonia Ice Hockey Program. Off the draw on the inside corner. Fredonia in the attacking zone. Bobby Polajek loses the puck. It dances behind him all the way down to Bogart. Tipped up Fredonia. That was Matt Letmanski getting circled around, trying to dodge a hit. Fredonia enters the Plattsburgh zone. A shot from the blue line there. Charlie Manley shooting it wide. Letmanski lays a hit on Fallinger of the Cardinals. So it gets turned around there. Max Blitz with a good dump into the far corner to keep that puck out from in front of Bogart. And Fredonia's own Letmanski lets one slide by him. Ian Walren dumps opposite corner as now Fredonia looks to play their way out of the inside. Off the glass into the glove of Arnaud for Plattsburgh. A shot in. Bogart lays down to make the save. Things get a little more knuckly out there again.
It's about the third or fourth time you've seen some pushing right in front of Bogart there this period.
Right, Fredonia and Plattsburgh. And the two teams that close in the standings. They know where they are. They know what game they're playing. Hugo Gamesh and Cam Owens line up for the draw. Excuse me, that was Ethan Kervis. Winning the draw, Fredonia comes away with it. They get it as far as the red line before Plattsburgh stifles that. Cam Owens with quick zone entry, a shot in on Bogart. Makes the glove save.
Really nice save from Bogart. He followed that one right into his glove and snagged that one out of midair.
Cardinals doing very well in the neutral zone right now, it would seem.
And Bogart, this year, he comes into tonight's game 9-4-1 record with a .922 save percentage, and he's allowing 2.51 goals per game. So, a tremendous amount of improvements from where he was at last year.
Asper Korsgenbauer trying to feed Luke Rivera going up through the attacking zone, but things misalign. Fredonia does have possession, but Tommy Martin, a shot in, and it's as far as the circle before it's turned back around. Number 16 for the Cardinals, Pat Egan, the goal scorer, turns this thing around. Here's Rivera with a shot in. It just goes past the shoulder of Jimmy Peruta. Fredonia maintains possession. Todd Schaus, Korsgenbauer behind the net. Plattsburgh with clean physical play to gain possession. Dumps off glass and into neutral ice. Turning that thing around is number 20, Mike Freeman, the captain for Fredonia. Dumped in right on the glove of Jimmy Peruta, where he makes the save.
No, another thing to watch for is Jimmy Peruta is only a sophomore, so I can't remember if he... Well, no, Plattsburgh wasn't here for a Pink the Rink last year, so this is his first Pink the Rink game in a hostile crowd. As puck gets worked back out to the point.
Fredonia has possession on the draw.
Yeah, we'll see how the young guy with Peruta, how he can respond to a hostile environment.
They do get a quick shot off. Plattsburgh turns it around the other way. Middleton trying to work things around. Now a four-way out front. In as opposed to Middleton on the roster. Fredonia looks to make a clear into the neutral zone. It is a tipped off a Plattsburgh stick, so there is no icing. Out of their own zone come the Cardinals. Up top, a shot in on Bogart, sent forth by Matt
Arroyo.
Arroyo.
Oh,
there we go. Use these pronunciation guides. Face-off coming to the right of Bogart. Loose puck as Fredonia will gain possession, trying to move it past the red line again. Lipmanski with a nice play. Goes up ice, across the blue line, now back in the Fredonia zone. Fredonia doesn't get as far as the neutral zone for their own ice. Moving up ice, this is going to be Chandler Judd, I believe. Oh, yes, Chandler Judd out there playing in his third game this season. The freshman coming in at 6'3", 200 pounds.
Yeah, a couple of younger guys that we've seen early on so far with Chandler Judd.
Lepmanski's fourth game now.
Yeah, and Lepmanski, a couple freshmen.
Slotting in for Pink the Rink night here. Saturday night from Steel Hall. Happy to be here. We're about halfway through this first period. 10:24 on the clock. It's 1-0 Cardinals so far. Fredonia has the puck in their own zone. A second chance shot there from Mike Freeman. Freeman retreats to the blue line where he finds the puck there. Tries to shoot it in. Ethan Kubis runs it, sees it goes through his feet. On the inside corner, Tyler Ryder trying to move that out. On the blue line, three Blue Devils collapse. As we're now on the near boards, foot slides all the way back down into the inside corner. Fredonia collects, they go the other way with it. Victor Tracy, the goal scorer from last night's third period heroics, turns it over for Barber as it gets dipped up behind Bogart. Charles Barber, number 21. Fredonia has the puck behind, out from behind the red net. Tachaus moves it towards the red line, trying to find his teammate Luke Rivera going forward. Gets dumped off the boards. Schaus finds his own pass behind the net of Pareda. Drifts all the way down there for Egan at the bottom of his own blue line. And the Cardinals go the other way. 3-on-3. Yet the net was there for Egan, but the pass was not misaligned. Bogart makes an excellent pad save. The puck is passed up. Malafoye gives it back to Egan. Ouzo down in the inside corner for Stollard. Puck is loose, but Fredonia almost tries to clear it. Turns it over. Another chance. Messy sequence. It's tipped up out of play.
Oh, a great handful of saves there by Bogart. He's really coming in clutch and very opportune moments for Plattsburgh.
I thought that one shot went in.
Yeah, it trickled right across the goal line.
Yeah,
the
players might have too. There was a temporary lull in the action. Fredonia was able to snap out of it before the Cardinals did, and they were quick to respond. Faceoff comes to the right of Bogart. They make their way up ice. Fredonia. Here comes Jimmy Morgan. Tipping up. Gets bounced into the inside corner of the Plattsburgh zone. 8:20 on the clock. 3-on-2, hiding behind the mess was Josh Biasuro, but Plattsburgh's quick to respond as they go 3-on-2, 3-on-3 the other way. Bogart makes the save.
Well, Bogart's been coming up big here with just about 12 minutes into this first period, but that being said, Fredonia's got to do a better job. They got to tighten up this defense. Too many times, Plattsburgh's getting into the zone and getting a lot of open shots.
Off the draw, left of Bogart. Fredonia collects the puck. They go into their corner with it. They get tangled up there. Puck remains. Fredonia has. Fredonia gives up possession. Plattsburgh gets a shot off. Barber from the blue line turns around. Fredonia loses control as they try to exit the zone. That was Tracy trying to self-pass. The stick goes across his chest.
Oh, wow. No penalty called on that. That was an elbow to the head.
On the hit. Taken down. Tracy's under his own power to the bench as they change out. Moving forward, Ryan Kuhn tips this behind the Fredonia net. They collect. The Blue Devils move forward. Polacek finds it at the inside blue, at the attacking blue line, but nothing can be done with it as they have to turn around and come back to their own zone again. This one's dumped all the way up for an icing.
I'm really surprised that there was no penalty called on that check on Tracy. It was right in front of us here at center ice, and I couldn't tell who that was for Plattsburgh, but it was he elbowed Tracy right in the head, and Tracy went down hard, but came away with no penalty.
A rough call there, a rough non-call, I suppose, as Fredonia will come away with this puck on the draw. Plattsburgh gets a quick shot off there from the stick of Arroyo before it gets dumped all the way back down again after the attack fails. We turn it around again. John Carlson moves forward for Todd Chouse. He's got three men in with him, but Plattsburgh's able to get in the middle there near. And Sloan does a nice dance to get to open ice. The shot moves through three Fredonians before going just wide of Bogart's net. Playing it forward there, Luke Rivera has to dance to avoid getting tripped up. Trying to move the puck forward, but it gets sent back behind Bogart's net in the inside corner of the Fredonia zone. A centering shot slides by Hurricane Barley. It's off center on the inside corner. And we wait as Plattsburgh and Fredonia go back and forth. It escapes to the neutral zone, but Jacob Engdahl is waiting for it. Dunks it back down in the inside corner. Fredonia will look to organize another rush. They find Jimmy Morgan going up ice. Morgan makes a hit to try and clear the way for his teammate, Jacob Haynes, but Cardinals steal the puck. Puck bounces off glass for Chenikov. Dips it down behind Bogart's net for his teammate, Arroyo, there with Walgren. Shot in, Fredonia has to collect the puck from neutral ice. As they go the other way with it, Plattsburgh. Now Lafleurier trying to find the loose puck up front. Middleton in the neutral zone. Dunks it off glass by Max Blitz in the attacking zone. Temporarily as Stollard sneaks by his defender. Gets a shot off on Bogart, but he eats it right up.
And again, Bogart coming up big. And again, the Fredonia defense just allowing him to skate in and get that shot.
Faceoff assembling to the... I had a sneaking suspicion about that. Faceoff sitting to the left of Bogart. Plattsburgh has 20 shots on net right now, and Fredonia trailing pretty far behind. Only three. Wow. Here's going to be another one.
And another nice save from Bogart.
Egan had a yawning open net, but he could not find a line to pass. Fredonia will try to turn it around. They'll get it as far as the red line once again before they lose control and dump. Fanga on the inside boards. Up ice. McCartney finds the loose puck, dips it all the way around. Rosenberg tries to clear, but Cohn finds it again. Rosenberg tries to clean up his mess, but Belenga is there on the loose puck before he is. Bobby Polacek and his move forward. Todd Schaus going forward with Judd, trying to get it on net. It bounces around the Chandler Judd and Matt Letbensky trying to organize something there off at semblance of a rush. Fredonia has a loose puck in front of their own net. They have to knock the guy down to get it. Jacob Engdahl, the 6'7 defender, has to come down to the ice. Fredonia making a massive hit to move the puck forward. And here comes Arroyo, placing Mike Freeman to the Fredonia zone. The puck is still under Cardinal control. Walgren with a slap shot from the blue line. Saved by Bogart.
If you can hear it, this crowd is just waiting to erupt. There's only three shots Fredonia's generated, at least shots on net. And, a couple times when Fredonia comes in transition and, they have a 2-on-1 or a 3-on-2, the crowd's just waiting to explode. But so far, there's just been nothing to get too hyped for here.
Having trouble coming out of their own zone in this first period. 2:31 on the clock in this first period. Let's make our way forward. Fredonia trying to control it. Getting a stick in there was Draven, number 11, for the Cardinals. Tyler Ryder trying to find his way up ice. Nothing going there as the Cardinals collect out of their own inside corner. Moving it up ice. Aurelio. Sloan. Fredonia deflects it back for another chance. Cardinals cross back in the red line. Middleton off glass. Circles around, finding Malafoye and Ochenikov. Middleton comes down the blue line, finds the puck, makes the shot. Bogart makes the save with his glove.
So Plattsburgh has 25 shots now, and Fredonia is still with just three.
It's a perplexing situation. This might have been Bogart on his head right now. This, we're looking at a game that very easily could be about 4-5-0. Out of the inside corner, Fredonia gives up the shot. Plattsburgh makes the shot again, a second chance. Bogart has to leap to die at that one. Shot coming all the way back from the blue line as Charles Barber.
Yeah, Bogart is probably the only player on the Blue Devils right now that's keeping the team in the game at the moment. Again, like you said, 25 shots. Most teams, on average, might have that at the end of the second period, but Plattsburgh has just been peppering on
Plattsburgh had a high momentum swing. Off that last night's game where they beat Buff State 3-0. Let's go Devils, the chant here from the Steel Hall crowd. They're now inside their own zone. That was athletic director Jerry Fisk starting the chant. Very distinct voice. Once you know it, it's hard to miss it. Plattsburgh has possession entering into the Fredonia zone as they get a shot off. Last minute is the call. Tucked around behind Bogart. Fredonia goes back and forth with it as they look to exit the zone. 45 seconds on the clock. Jacob Haynes dumps it. Fredonia will go out for one last change there. That is Jimmy Morgan trying to pester Plattsburgh into giving him possession. Eakin, the inside of the neutral zone, switches out with his teammate. They will go off ice with it. A shot all the way from the streaming Joe Draven. Bogart makes the save. 24 on the clock.
So 29-3 now is the total. 30 to 3. You just never see that.
Plattsburgh having Fredonia stand still beyond their own zone. Permanent defense here for this first period. That's an icing on Fredonia as we go back down to Bogart's end of the ice.
You know, Plattsburgh's just outplaying Fredonia in every aspect of the game right now other than the goaltending. Their defense has been great. You know, Fredonia can't get anything going on offense, and their offense has been really well, too. And Fredonia has no answers.
Off the faceoff. Under 10 seconds to go. Fredonia has possession. They will most likely stall for time here as the clock will expire.
Score at the end of the first period is Plattsburgh 1, Fredonia no score.
So, that's at the end of only one period. Shots are, we'll leave you with these numbers for the moment. Shots are 30-3.
And Fredonia is very lucky that the score is only 1-0 right now.
We'll let you digest this period, and we'll be back with a quick intermission report. And coming out the head for the second period, Chris Hoyt will take you through the second period. So we'll see you. We're back for the intermission report. I'm WNYF, WNYF, yeah, we'll mention them first. WNYF TV, that's the YouTube live feed, youtube.com, throw WNYF TV in the search bar. You can find the live stream right at the top of the videos tab, WCBF 89 The Voice, WDBR 9.5 The Inferno, all available online streams for the radio.com, during athletics. The Hockey Night in Fredonia, we're going to take you into the intermission. We'll be back in just a few moments.
We're not going to take it. WNYF Television, YouTube Live, WNYF TV in the search bar. Your first video probably up on the top of that tab. Fredonia Boxcast, the athletics website, long list, but however you're listening to us, we're happy that you're here as we kick off the second period here. Hockey Night in Fredonia, of course, Jarrett Belschwinder, Kevin Syracuse, and joining me, that's for the second period here, Chris Hoyt.
Thank you again, Jared. Happy to be here.
There he is. We are underway as things get back in the swing here. Fredonia once again looking to attain more than three shots.
Way more.
Way more.
And gotta have more than zero goals.
Gonna have to pick back, hit things back up here as Fredonia comes out of play.
Fredonia needs to completely flip the switch here. Like I said in the first period, the only thing they had going for him was Eric Bogart. He kept them in this game so far. He's been outstanding, 29 saves, and the one goal that he allowed wasn't even his fault. It was just a defensive breakdown, and Plattsburgh found the open net. So, it, like I said, complete flip the switch.
Back faceoff to the right of Bogart. Plattsburgh driving possession. Slides by a couple Fredonians. Dunks into the corner. Out of neutral ice, it's number 18, Matt Arroyo. Shoots it in high off the netting. Out of play.
One thing to note as well, Plattsburgh has had two men in on the forecheck at all times. We didn't see that last night from Potsdam. They stuck with mainly a one guy in and four guys back. The two guys pressure from Plattsburgh has been giving Fredonia a lot of trouble. That's something to keep an eye on going here in the period. They've had the offensive possession thus far, so they haven't had to forecheck much, but that's definitely something to keep an eye on moving forward here.
Off the draw at center ice. Tipped up, out of play.
Coach caught that one.
Through the fog.
Yeah, that smoke from the Blue Devils tunnel is still dissipating.
Next on the docket, rink ventilation. Fredonia gets possession off the neutralized faceoff. They chase it down to the attacking zone. Tyler Ryder with a shot in. That's going to be shot number four. More or less a strong hit there by Tracy, I believe, to try and maintain possession. However, Plattsburgh turns it around. Tracy finds it at the blue line, trying to feed Corsic and Barley. But it doesn't get much further than that. Turned right back around by the Cardinals. Here comes Nayer. Onto the inside corner, shot in. Bogart makes the save. From back in the inside. Nayer still has it. Gives way for Joe Draven. Off the blue line, a shot by his teammate, Jakob Angerball. Turns it around. Corsic and Barley for the Blue Devils. Tries to turn it. Find an open pass. DeFelice with a nice move to gain possession at the blue line. Fredonia with a simple tap and clear as they go for a change. Plattsburgh maintains possession. McCartney turns it around. Out of the inside of the neutral zone. Moving it away. Plattsburgh has possession. McCartney coming up past the blue line. Gives back to DeFelice. Polacek finds the loose puck at the side of Bogart's net. They turn it around. Three on three in even rush. Dipped all the way. Chandler Judd chasing behind the net. Fredonia at plan to play out of the inside corner. Charlie Manley with a shot. Gets it to Chandler Judd just inside the blue line. Polacek passes back. Blitz, a shot high and wide just all the way from the top of the blue line. The Cardinals find the puck at the far end of the Fredonia bench. Play it out of neutral ice. They dump for the clear. Fredonia looking to advance the puck out. Trying to pass to Matt Letmanski, who chases the tumbling puck in. Can't collect the loose one. The net of Jimmy Poreda. Charlie Manley with a nice defensive play there to bring number 20 Cole Stollard back under control. Fredonia sends the puck ahead for Jacob Haynes, trying to settle it in. Freda makes the save.
Possession looking to be a lot more 50-50 here in the second period, Jarrett. You know, Fredonia is doing a lot better being calculated in their defensive zone and also a lot better in the offensive zone, looking more put together, trying to run specific looks to try to get more chances on the pads of Jimmy Pareda.
Well, they already have two-thirds of the amount of shots that they did in the first period.
In fairness, unfortunately, that's not too hard to do.
Yeah.
Off the draw, Malafourier and John Carlson chasing things. John Carlson will win the race for the icing as they retreat all the way back. Faceoff coming to the right.
The last play we saw there was some good effort from Matt Letmanski, able to beat Ian Walgren to the puck, who blew a tire on the way to negate that icing, allowing Fredonia to get a pair of offensive zone faceoffs now.
Offensive zone faceoff, trying to generate a chance. Fredonia, puck slides past them. Ochenikov wins the race to the loose puck out of inside ice, trying to turn it out. Fredonia goes back and forth behind Bogart. They find the far pass all the way to Tyler Reiter at the blue line. He trickles himself offside, losing control.
A tough break there for Fredonia. Reiter just a step offsides, which negated what was looking to be a pretty good offensive chance there for the Blue Devils. Faceoff come back out to the neutral zone now in front of the Fredonia bench.
Off the draw, clean win for the Cardinals. DeVelis dipping back as Fredonia is able to find it. The back going back and forth in neutral ice. Jacob Haynes chases a puck in the air, lands on the stick of number 21 for the Cardinals. Charles Barber gives to his teammate, Jacob Engvall. Excuse me. Bogart makes the save.
No, Jared, I keep hearing you say DeFelis. I automatically think of Tommy.
We do remember Tommy DeFelis. However, this is going to be Plattsburgh's player.
Christian DeFelis. I believe Tommy graduated last year. If not last year, it was the year before.
Off the draw. Working the way across the three lines, Fredonia. Staples are to the inside corner to try and create a play. Plattsburgh's able to whisk that one back. Owens works his way back up ice. Jacob Haynes clearing the way for Max Blitz as Fredonia enters to the zone on the inside. Hugo Gamache trying to advance that puck. That is Luke Rivera instead of Hugo Gamache.
One sign of progression you like to see throughout a game from the team is how they leave their defensive zone and how they enter their offensive zone. Fredonia doing a better job of both here in the second period, able to get some clean zone exits on their way out and get pucks deep much better than they had in the first 20 minutes of play here. Let's look for them to keep honing in on that possession style they like to play here going forward.
A chance for Fredonia. It winds up going wide of the netminder Pareda. Fredonia looking to play, can't get his stick on that puck. Luke Rivera, however, it hangs out in the neutral zone just long enough for Todd Schaus to find it. Receives a neat dish from Ryan Rosenberg.
He has a nice pass from Rosenberg and a nice shot from Schaus. And just, if it was a couple inches to the left or the right, I think that one would have went in, but Pareda was able to make the save and it deflected out of play.
That was definitely their best offensive chance of the night. A nice shot there from Schaus from the left faceoff circle.
Off the draw here comes Plattsburgh as Fredonia collects the bouncing puck in their own zone, giving it up. Shoveling it just wide was Daniil Ochenikov. through the crease. It gets banged around again. That is Middleton for the Cardinals. DeFelice calling for the loose puck. Can't find it. Fredonia is able to get in the way of that. Ethan Kirbis trying to turn this play around. John Carlson and Victor Tracy playing back and forth on the far corner boards of the Fredonia defensive zone. On the red line, Fredonia collects. Tracy with a weak shot that trickles wide of Poeta. Moving around, Fredonia sneaks it around. Stollard almost getting ahead of Carlson. However, Fredonia's able to turn the play around. Chandler Judd stamping it down and moving it around. Trying to find an open player at the blue line. Finds Blitz. Gets deflected out in front. Bounces back towards the neutral zone. Fredonia with another chance here. Trying to turn things around. Can't advance past their own blue line. Turn it back around. A deflect from Polichuk. Just inside the red line. Goes for icing.
An unfortunate bounce there off of Polichuk, but that last shift from the Judd, Letmanski, and Polichuk line, definitely a lot of effort put in, and another decent offensive chance. What I would have liked to have seen from Blitz there on the point, he sort of tried to force a shot through. I would like to see him keep possession of the puck, keep working around in the cycle to get more offensive possession there.
Plattsburgh clears. They gain possession off the draw. They clear the circle. On the inside corner, they're fishing around for it, going back and forth, trying to peel it out. Ross Sloan for the Cardinals. Max Blitz has it at his own blue line, dunks it off the boards, just outside of the red line. Fredonia trying to peel the play off the attacking boards now as Corey Barley turns a nice small backhander in on Parieta. But the Cardinals are able to come away with it. Finds Luke Rivera almost, but he's pestered all the way by Joe Draben. Rivera not able to get a playoff as Fredonia still on the boards, trying to turn it around. Moving it away are the Cardinals, dunked away for loose in the neutral zone. Rivera can't find it in his skates. It gets cleared all the way. This one's a loose play, an errant miss call. That was going to be Mike Freeman, who thought his teammate was just there behind him, but instead it was a Plattsburgh player coming off the bench. Luckily, Fredonia was able to securely move it out of harm's way. We resume coverage. Neutral ice, Victor Tracy. Second chance play there. Tyler Reiter dumps it in behind the netminder, Poeta. Off the circle, McCartney for the Cardinals. Going up ice with it. He's got his teammate, Cohen. Going at the circle, turns it around. Shot wide, McCartney gives back to Aruzzo. A shot in, Fredonia, that looked like Biasulo getting in the way of the play. Fredonia will turn themselves around. Behind, some action behind the play. A couple of small conversation as Plattsburgh turns it around out of the far corner of the attacking zone. Fredonia gets it right back. Jacob Haynes finding Jimmy Morgan, trying to make a play, stifled right in the net front once again. They turn it around. Pareda clears into the inside corner. Haynes trying to fish it out there. Charlie Manley trying to make a play. Going away on the top boards. Jacob Haynes trying to cherry pick the stick of Stallard. the Cardinals are able to maintain possession. Jacob Haynes tries to find an open man, Luke Rivera, but he is taken down. There will be a call. Trying to spin around out in front was Luke Rivera. He was taken down.
That was a really nice pass from Haynes down low into Rivera. And I think they're going to call him for either holding or tripping.
Jacob Enval will be taking a seat for being too tall.
Yeah, 6'7".
It didn't look like much was going to come of that possession there by Rivera, but he was able to muscle around the defenseman there, Engvall, and get a decent shot on net there on Pareda, and it results in a power play for the Blue Devils just over halfway through the second period.
The tall defenseman is an interesting dynamic because you see it all the time with Zdeno Chara, the Boston Bruins. He's making simple defensive plays, and just he's too high up there to have proper control of the stick down on the ice.
So the penalty was for holding.
Holding will be the call. 2 minutes on the power play for Fredonia. 9:09 in this second period. Already a much better looking period here for Fredonia. See if they can tie this up on the power play. As Carlson has the puck behind the net of Oreda. Gets cleared. Bogart goes back to collect. Fredonia slowly but surely trying to climb their way out of the hole in the first period. Plattsburgh only at 32 shots. Fredonia at 8. A small and marginal improvement.
Yeah, Fredonia is playing better, but still not great. So let's see what they can do here.
Chance at the blue line. Passing back and forth. Max Blitz and Charlie Manley gives to Jacob Haynes. Blitz again. A shot in. Manley from the blue line, a shot is loose. The puck then winds up being loose. Cleared all the way right into Bogart's pads. Tracy. Manley makes his way up ice.
25 seconds left on the penalty.
Circling around. Another clear. Fredonia looking for one last chance off a rush here. Now with 10 to go, looks like they'll just settle to regroup and set up, use the remainder of their advantage in the neutral zone. They will dump as the penalty expires. As Chandler Judd almost had a loose puck there at the right side of Jimmy Pareda's net. Where it slid by him and puck tumbles all the way back down into the Fredonia zone. Plattsburgh trying to make a play of it. Kuhn out in front of the net mouth. Fredonia doing good to get in the way of that, and then Todd Schaus will use his speed, try and find someone at center, out at center. But McCartney is the one who winds up finding the puck for the Cardinals. It's
penalty coming
wide
up for Fredonia.
That's going to be on the captain, Mike Freeman there. Took down Ryan Kuhn for Plattsburgh to the left of Jimmy Pareda. Went down hard into the wall, actually, and sort of limbering his way back to the bench now.
.647 on the clock. 2 minute penalty assessed to Fredonia.
So Fredonia will go on the penalty kill, where they are 77 for 99 this year.
Just about 80%.
Meanwhile, Plattsburgh is 8 for 92 on the power play.
8 for 92 on the penalty, on the power play here. Fredonia defending off the draw. Walgren passes up ice. To Aruzzo, a shot in, it deflects off the leg of Owens there, the captain, number 19. He gets right back up and jockeys for a screen against John Carlson, but Bogart's able to make the save.
One thing is Bogart's stayed on this period. You know, he's kept his eye on the puck very well. One thing you don't want to see is him sort of fall asleep here with the sort of lack of action he's faced here in the period after facing 30 shots in the first, but he hasn't done that at all. He's been focused, eyes on the puck, and he'll face some more shots here with a minute and a half still left on the penalty kill for your Blue Devils.
Out of the circle. Fredonia will find the clear. Dump down, the smoke machine goes off for one reason or another. Then Plattsburgh regains control. Owens speeds through neutral ice, has Egan on the wing, Wahlgren behind. Egan will dish back to Wahlgren at the blue line. Wahlgren gives back to Egan, then Egan gives back to Wahlgren, and Wahlgren gives back to Egan. They go back and forth at the blue line, circle around. Owens passes back to Egan, who passes in turn back to Wahlgren. Wahlgren tips in front. Owens left alone in the net front, gets his stick on the ice and tips it up. Top shelf. 2-0 Plattsburgh.
Just good puck movement from the Cardinals and good shot, good deflection, nothing Bogart could do.
Ian Wahlgren was waiting there at the point to unleash a howitzer there for a good 15, 20 seconds and finally gets the opportunity to do so. A snapshot there. And as you said, tipped in front by the captain, Cam Owens. So Plattsburgh going up 2-0 there on the power play.
2-0, a whistle off the draw. Some sort of face-off violation as we head back into the Plattsburgh zone here. They will have the face-off coming to the left of the netminder, Jimmy Poreda. So restart this game. A quick shot there. Jacob Haynes makes a well-placed split-second decision as Fredonia, they get that shot on net. 36-8. About 5:21 here in this second period. Jacob Haynes moves his way up ice. Gives it. Morgan finds it in his skates. Surrenders it though off a hit as Plattsburgh makes their way up ice. Draven gives it to Sloan trying to find Nair. Out at the net mouth. It bounces off the backside of his skate and they can't make it happen. Fredonia finds a chance. It's sent in off the pads of Plattsburgh's Poreda. Turn it back around. Middleton, Malaforie going 2-on-1 right up to the net. They will try and Middleton makes a quick circle of the net.
And Bogart just got his pad out to stop that. That was inches away from going into the net and
I saw it tumble with some space, too.
Yeah.
Said the same thing last night. Potsdam had a chance, and like I said, if Bogart was 6'5 and a half, that puck was in. Good thing he's got 6'6 of his frame. They're able to stick the pad out with a toe save to get the defensive zone faceoff here.
Off the draw. Rosenberg has it behind his own net. Mike Freeman, the captain, as well. Trying to go back and forth with it. It bounces off the boards and back up towards Bogart where he elects to make the save.
No momentum swing after that goal either. Just as we saw in the first period after Plattsburgh scored, they still maintained possession of the puck and were the primary force of offensive pressure there. And they're doing a little bit of the same here after their second goal. Fredonia not quite able to get out of their defensive zone as well as they were in the majority of the second period here.
Plattsburgh has possession off the draw. They get forced into their own zone. Across net front pass stifled by the Cardinals. That's number 13, Ochinnikov, getting in the way of that. Ochinnikov has it at the top of the red line. They're going back and forth with it. Tumbles all the way down. No icing as collecting will be Brendan Spagnardi. Going up ice, this is an icing. Fredonia gets ahead of Luke Rivera, who slams a stick into the boards out of frustration.
And you know, It is possible, obviously, to score two goals in the third period, but you don't want to go into the third period down 2-0. Fredonia needs to score here at least once before the end of the period and get some momentum going into the third period.
So we mentioned those weird and wacky momentum swings that Fredonia seems to have. Well, one of those would be extremely useful right now as Plattsburgh has the puck in their own zone. Steel Hall ready to explode when it comes to a situation, but this is going to be a penalty coming towards the Blue Devils themselves. They're screaming at right now is P-Dub's Pizza.
Sad to say, but it's a lot of St. Ben.
Unfortunately, yeah. I want to go back to that last play Spagnardi tried to make to Rivera there. What you like to see is they haven't been taking too many chances like that here in the first 35 or so minutes. You know, you're going to need to see that quicker pace of play and the more stretch passes like that one that Spagnardi was trying to get to Rivera here if they want to come back in the game. And it is Spagnardi going to the box for 2 minutes.
This penalty kill is huge because I just said you can't go down 2-0. You really can't go into the third period down 3-0.
Holding the call as Fredonia is on the penalty kill once again. Plattsburgh has possession in the zone. McCartney receives a pass from his teammate. As they go back and forth into the inside. Ross Sloan comes out of the corner. Back and forth, McCartney finds it. That's Barber. The Barber almost lines up for the slap shot, but it gets tipped away by Fredonia. Tyler Reiter trying to put a puck on net. They score! Short-handed goal for Fredonia.
Kevin, you were just saying that penalty kill itself was huge. I was about to say the next goal itself is huge for this game. Fredonia able to capitalize here short-handed, and that is a big one here towards the end of the second period. Looks like it was Jimmy Morgan heading to the bench first, so he'll be credited with a goal here.
Yeah, that was huge. That was just great defense turned into offense. Reiter with a beautiful pass to Morgan, and this deficit is cut in half, and it's 2-1.
Tyler Reiter, just enough sauce on that pass to get it over the stick of the Plattsburgh defender. And as we said, Jimmy Morgan able to bury it behind the goaltender, Pin Pareda.
Excellent speed by Fredonia as they look to capitalize off this quick momentum swing. An excellent offensive breakout on the penalty kill.
The crowd is back into it.
Guys, this reminds me of last night's game as well. Potsdam had a power play, a 5-on-3 here at the end of the second period, and they were able to capitalize twice and tie the game heading into the third. Tonight, Fredonia flipping the script on Plattsburgh, able to get a shorthanded goal, which is nice here with less than 3 minutes to play.
Trying to clear is Fredonia, can't get it. It's fanned on. Walgren at the blue line. Goes back with Aruzzo at the circle. There, Cole Stollard. Owens up back to Stollard. Dips behind him at the blue line. Walgren. Is the pass. Aruzzo back to Walgren. Down the ice. Egan at the out from underneath the circle. Trying to dim. Plattsburgh collapses on the net slowly but surely. Aruzzo scores. Cole Stollard with a simple shot from the circle.
They were running the same sort of look there. Cam Owens down in the near right side corner. Out to Egan and then back to Walgren. As opposed to going to Walgren this time, like he did on their last power play goal, he went across to Stallard and he was able to pot one home over the right shoulder of Bogart.
Yeah, that was just a really well-placed shot. And Plattsburgh scores on the power play and back to a two-goal game.
Nips Fredonia right in the bud here at the end of the second. It's got a minute 45 on the clock. It's now 3-1 for the Cardinals. As they make their way up ice, Fredonia has the puck in the offensive zone, trying to turn it around. Getting in the way of that was number two, Jakob Engvall. The absolute giant out there amongst the rest of the players. again. Engvall coming in at 6'7". The 6'7" Swede. He's one of the two on defense as Victor Tracy had an open net chance on Boreda, but it deflected up on off his glove.
That was a nice job by Tracy. He caught the puck in the neutral zone, put it down, skated in, put a nice move on his defender. Problem is he shot it right at Boreda. It looked like from our vantage point that he had right corner, Pareda's left corner open, but you know, don't know.
It was a closing window as our eyes hit it.
Pareda squats, that's what it is. He had a real big burst there, jumping up to able to shoulder that one away.
Off the draw. Final minute coming up here in the second. Fredonia looking. But Plattsburgh will come away with the puck. Out from behind the net. That's Nair. Trying to move away with it. He'll retreat to the bench for a change. Coming right back off in response there. Egan. Plattsburgh's best line back out there. So they turn it around. Going out as the Cardinals advance past the red line. Here comes Sloan. Dumping it in. Fredonia trying to find Todd Schaus, who can't turn around on Aruzzo. Stollard turns it around. He's got Egan in the inside corner. Middleton feeds back from the blue line. Owens makes a shot. Cross ice, but the clock expires.
And now shots are 39-12.
So more of a normal second period, but there's still plenty to talk about coming up on the intermission. As we will take a quick step back here, and we'll see you in just a few moments as we here on WCVF 88.9 The Voice, WDVL 89.5 The Inferno, WNYF TV, Fredonia Radio, FredoniaRadio.com, of course, FredoniaAthletics.com as well. Here coming up, we will have the intermission. We will have the intermission report for you in just a few moments. As I will play Toto.
crease pass, and he went ahead to go sprawling across the net to even reach the shot. But, you know, not his fault tonight. We'll see how the third period goes here shortly.
Yes, it will be a very, very interesting third. And hopefully our hometown Blue Devils can pull off a nice little comeback and really shock Plattsburgh.
We'll be back in just a few seconds here for this third period here on Hockey Night in Fredonia. We'll be back. From Steel Hall Hockey Night in Fredonia as we are underway. I'm Jarrett Belschwinder. Got Kevin Syracuse here with me. Turn that down. Yeesh. Kevin Syracuse and Colin Woods back here for your third period of action. The Plattsburgh Cardinals up 3-1 in this period, and already it looks like Fredonia is in a slight bit of trouble.
Yeah, it looked like Fredonia was going to come out with the two-on-one breakaway here, but now Ethan Kerbis is going to be in the box. So,
yeah, a team that's already hurting is just pressing more salt into the wound, and it's really stinging them.
So 2 minutes for cross-checking, not even 20 seconds into the third period.
Fredonia down here. Oh, man, two-minute power play coming for the Cardinals. Two power play goals already scored by the line of Egan Owens and Stollard. And they're right back out there. They go left, center, right from the circle.
I mean, the only goal Fredonia scored tonight has been shorthanded, so maybe they can work some magic again.
Maybe, certainly. They had their weird tendency last night was every goal came to our right here. See if Fredonia can make the penalty kill work for them. Plattsburgh has possession in their own zone there. Aruzzo has possession. Gives it back to Egan. A shot in. Stollard collects the rebound off of boards. Egan, a shot in, gives it to Owens. Egan just narrowly misses the net. It bounces off into the glass. Turn it around, Stollard has a chance. Bogart's able to easily stop it. Fredonia gets the clear.
Minute gone in the penalty.
Aruzzo behind his own net. Going up ice with it. Solid hit on the boards. Max Blitz takes up McCartney. As Fredonia turns the play around for a clear, Barber collects the puck in his own zone. Looking to exit on the rush here. Fredonia's gonna throw three men up front, and they wipe the clear all the way down the ice under 30 on the penalty now. Regrouping once again, going up ice. Here's Middleton crossing the red line, then the blue. He loses control. It's sent all the way down. Carlson, Rivera finds it. Carlson clears the full 200 feet. And the penalty expires as Ethan Kerbis exits the box.
Oh, yes, much better penalty kill there for the Blue Devils.
Strong clears, gets tangled up in the neutral zone as Fredonia looks to go away with it. Todd Schaus trying to cross the blue line, getting in the way. Ochenikov in the way. Middleton clears, gives it to Ochenikov. Ochenikov has the open net side, tries to pass to Middleton. Bogart gets across, makes the stop. Fredonia goes the other way. Biasulo trying to set it on net, but he's passes thwarted. On the inside, here comes Jacob Haynes. Has a second man in. The shot is wide. Biasulo was waiting on the other side of the net. Plattsburgh gains possession. They go the other way. Here comes Sloan, number 26, in on Bogart. Making that neat stop there was Max Blitz. Fredonia collects in their own zone. They go up ice with it. Trying to front up, three men on two. Finds Tracy with a shot, had the open mount, had the net in front of him, but so was the netminder, Porrieta. The Cardinals turn it around. McCartney dumps and clears for the line change just inside of the red line. Oh, it bounces up on Aruzzo. He loses control of it, spins around a couple times. Chandler Judd was there to try and gain a chance out just on the side of the net. Plattsburgh dumps it back all the way behind Bogart. Stollard on the boards. John Carlson turns it around for Fredonia. Here's Tommy Martin, who dishes all the way trying to find Judd. And Aruzzo drifting into the glove of Jimmy Porrieta.
Well, I mentioned it last period how Fredonia needs to completely flip the switch, and they started to last period, and then, you know, Plattsburgh was able to score that goal again. So
losing momentum on the power play, yes.
So now they're in the same position. It's just a total flip of the switch here. Plattsburgh's still dominating this game. So we'll see how mentally tough Fredonia is.
Bugnardi initially lets that puck fly out of the zone, but Fredonia's able to quickly reset themselves and get back on side. As Fredonia has possession on the inside boards, it gets clear to neutral ice. There, Rosenberg sets it down and sends it the other way. Possible icing as the Plattsburgh coach appeals here. This play is going to be whistled down as we return to neutral ice for the faceoff.
Shots are now up to 42-13. So Bogart already with 39 saves with 15 minutes still remaining in the game.
Off the draw, Plattsburgh has control. Jakub Engvall. The whistle blows before the puck gets blown into the net.
That's very favorable in Fredonia.
Looks like an offside or an icing.
This is a weird call here, Jared.
Yeah, I think they're gonna call it icing. It looks like.
All right. It's kind of a weak call, but I mean we'll take it.
Interesting call in favor of Fredonia as the faceoff comes to the right of Boyeda. Plattsburgh has control, but that's Tyler Ryder getting in the way of that.
Oh, no penalty called. Ryder's right. Stick was getting held.
Yes. Tommy Martin down to win the race against Malaforier.
Yeah, what just happened, I'm surprised it didn't get called for a penalty. It was a hooking call against Plattsburgh, but the refs just didn't see it, and but fortunately for Fredonia, it is back down in the Plattsburgh end on icing call.
And Tyler Ryder borderline out front of the net as well. Interesting move there. Kirbis finds the puck off the draw, shoots it in, gets tangled up in the feet of the Plattsburgh defensive screen. Trying to peel that off the boards himself was Ryder, but he gives it up. Owens using speed all the way to get into the zone. Can't find it off the circle. He goes. Bounces up in through neutral ice, free. In direction, McCartney drifts it back into Fredonia ice, trying to self-pass was Tommy Martin. Off the inside boards, Plattsburgh has control. It bounces up, wristed away as DeFelice enters in to the zone, unloads a shot just over the head of Bogart. Again, that is Christian DeFelice, number 23 for Plattsburgh, not Tommy DeFelice, who graduated last year. For Fredonia, Bogart stops that puck. bounces around, goes back and forth before not even leaving the blue line. Carlson accidentally leaves it behind, trying to stuff it past the glove of Bogart was Ryan Cohn.
But like we have seen all game, Bogart has come in clutch here to make yet another simple but yet important save.
And Fredonia was struggling the whole time clearing it out of their own zone. Martin tried clearing again, knocked down to the blue line. Another shot was taken by the Cardinals, and then Carlson lost it off of his stick, and a wraparound opportunity. Thankfully, Bogart was there for Fredonia.
Off the draw, it is a 1-0 chance. Here is score! Jimmy Morgan on a 1-0 chance. It's 2-3.
What a beautiful breakaway for Fredonia. This is just what they needed. He went low, and it paid off big time going in back in the net.
And we're back to a one-goal game, 3-2.
Hashtag one goal. Chicago.
I didn't even, who got the assist on that? That was a beautiful pass.
Yeah, I'm
coming out of the neutral zone.
I mean, it was a long pass. It was either in the neutral zone or the Fredonia, it was somewhere around the blue line, but just a beautiful pass, and Morgan was wide open. And it's a 3-2 game.
An even strength goal for Fredonia. Gonna try and give them a huge momentum boost.
Oh.
Without a stick. That was Todd Schaus who had loads.
Caruba collision.
25. Yes.
Yeah, laid him out right the Fredonia blue
line. Tom Bowie. Another hit.
Oh my. I do not know what happened, but the Devils are coming out right now. Very powerful goal.
Manley's going to have a secondary assist on that goal. I could not hear who the primary assist was. But if I had to wager that, it could very well be Max Blitz, who have paired very well together defensively so far.
Yeah, I couldn't hear it either. But just a beautiful pass. Morgan was able to finish it.
Fredonia and Plattsburgh back and forth through the neutral zone. Look out, here's a loose puck for Plattsburgh, but it's whiffed on by Malaforie. He finds his way back to the net front for a second chance. Whiffed again, Barber from the blue line, knocked down by the stick of Tracy. Sentenced to the corner as Fredonia looks to exit their own zone. Are going to do so, try and fight their way up. Tracy is going for a change. Fredonia will change out off that dump. Jacob Haynes driving the play, trying to work for a chance. Accidentally losing control for a brief moment was Jakob Engvall. Another player without their stick.
Okay, so Ethan Kerbis was the one with the nice pass.
Ethan Kerbis.
Yes, The very long pass, very, very difficult to pull off, but if executed properly, magic will happen.
And the crowd is back into it. It was pretty silent in here for the majority of this game, other than, you know, the first goal scored for Fredonia, but they are back into it now.
Halfway through the third period, Fredonia only down by one now, thanks to a goal by Jimmy Morgan. Sprung on a breakaway by Ethan Kirbis. Look out, though. Here's a slap shot from number 20, Cole Stollard. Nice play trying to work their way out of the inside corner. The Fredonia zone. The Blue Devils will try and come away with it there. Jimmy Morgan wins the puck away at a one-on-one open ice battle, clears it temporarily as Plattsburgh dumps it back down. Fredonia collects behind their own net, looks to make their way out of the zone. Out of control from Max Blitz, bounces off the crossbar, a shot.
No, that was off of his face mask.
There's the mask save. Polichek battles that one all the way into the far corner. into the inside boards. Fredonia looking for a chance. Tommy Martin, a weak shot in, drifts just wide. Gloved to the side by Poryeda. Kuhn for the Cardinals in there with McCartney trying to spin and turn it on net. Can't do it as Fredonia finds it and clears to neutral ice. It gets knocked down, a delayed icing. Waved off as the Cardinals reset. Into their own corner, Fredonia, the puck drifts accidentally out in front. Bogart's able to direct it back out of harm's way. A second chance, Fredonia there on the net front as they go two on two. Here comes Todd Schaus. Strong hit by Jakob Engervall, the 6'7 defenseman lays it out on Jasper Korsigan Barley. Plattsburgh's able to turn it around. They're back in the attacking zone. A shot on. It's loose from Bogart's mitt, but he's able to leave that in the care of Ethan Kirbis as he advances it out of the zone. Fredonia trying to set up. Gets bounced around, and then Owens tries to bring it net front, but Fredonia sends it back the other way. And they go back into the corner. Fredonia circling around. Up on the far corner, Tyler Ryder. Long pass out from behind the net. Gets it to Tracy, but he's got someone there to annoy him. It's number 18, Matt Arujo. Spun around Owens. Is able to separate the puck from the player as the Cardinals go back and forth. Another non-call. This time looks like it might be a possible penalty that would have been assessed to Fredonia.
Well, the speed of this game is definitely picking up now. We're under 9 minutes to go. It's back to a one-goal game, and the physicality is getting up there.
Closing in on 50 shots for the Cardinals. We're up to 46. Fredonia's at 15. Fredonia was able to score a goal when they reached 10. Perhaps they can get another one when they reach 20.
That would be nice.
Yeah, judging by the weird quirks of hockey.
If you were to look at the stat sheet here and see shots were in favor of Plattsburgh 46-15, I don't think anyone would be guessing that we're in a 3-2 game right now.
Right. Very well. Plattsburgh very well out of that first period could have four or five. Three or four other chances came in the second and partway through the third here.
You do have to remember, sometimes it's not about how many shots you put on, it's about how accurate they are.
Of course.
Quality, not quantity.
Down the blue line for Middleton. Sweeped away by Charlie Manley as Fredonia looks to go up ice. Jacob Haynes dodges a hit. Turning it around though, here's Salone. Dumps it in. Sloan gets it back. Can't make it work. Bogart's able to defuse that play. Fredonia circles around in their own zone, trying to find it. Goes through three layers there as they eventually clear out of his own net to control it there. Jimmy Poryeda turning it around. Fredonia back in their own zone. It's going back and forth, end to end. Out of control as Fredonia looks to go 3-on-3 up ice, trying to find Schaus.
Wow.
Who had a chance. That was a
big Rivera hit. Got blasted.
On Rivera.
And he is shooken up on that.
Rivera, the hardest workers out there. Another strong hit. I remember a couple games back, he took another one. Similar to that to try and make a play. At the far end of the red line, Fredonia trying to line up for zone exit, trying to make a play out of this one. Forced to dump off glass. Just ahead of the blue line was Brandon Spagnardi. Stallard's able to dodge him, though. The second layer of Rosenberg keeps that play from turning into a chance. Arujo has the puck in past the blue line, makes a shot on Bogart. He wrists it aside. Stallard behind his own net. Gets switched around, and Fredonia once again looks to exit. There, Morgan guides a good pass to Haynes, but it gets deflected up high and out of play over the glass.
Yeah, Rivera, that was one of the hardest hits we've seen, as he's was getting looked at on the bench by the athletic trainer, but now he's back on the bench. So hopefully he's gonna be okay, but that was just really hard hit. The whole board shook on that one.
We're off the draw, faceoff coming to the right of Barrieta. The left, we got some more physicality here as Middleton meets up on the boards with Rosenberg. Morgan, rather, yes. Jimmy Morgan and Philip Middleton getting in some intense conversation as we reset for the draw. Turning it around, Fredonia has play, has possession in the attacking zone, trying to keep that out of harm's way. Jimmy Morgan continues to go back and forth with Middleton, the two defending each other well. Here's an open ice chance. Can't get in the way. Morgan was finding his way to the net mouth, but he gets taken up by two defenders. Morgan elects to dump in right into the glove of Barrieta, who then closes it and draws the whistle.
So 5 minutes, 40 seconds here. Devils are still looking for that tying goal. Got a nice faceoff right next to Plattsburgh.
We are nearing crunch time here. Five and a half left to go. 3-2.
Possibly more late game heroics in store here on Hockey Night in Fredonia. WCVF 88.9 The Voice, WDVL 89.5 The Inferno, WNYF TV as well. Fredonia up, down only by one. It's 2-3 in favor of the Cardinals with 5:13 here in the third period. Shot out of play there, trying to make a dump to the neutral zone from his own zone was Jakob Angerval.
Shots are now 48-17.
Just a reminder, this is the final home game of the regular season for the Blue Devils. Two more games on the road in Morrisville.
And they are all huge games.
That is correct.
Winning this game would set the tone for that weekend. Certainly. Fredonia indeed in position to make the SUNYAC playoffs, but who they face is very much up to them right now.
Another hard hit, and Fredonia's going to pick up a penalty on this.
As Owens gets a shot in on Bogart.
Same type of hit into the boards that Rivera got. Difference is Fredonia's going to the box, it looks like. Tyler Ryder.
This is definitely not what Fredonia needs right now. This is their fourth penalty, and they've gotten scored on two out of the three so far. So let's try to make it 2-4 here for penalties.
Faceoff coming to the right of Bogart. Fredonia down a man.
Fredonia penalty number 24, Tyler Ryder, 2 minutes for roughing.
Roughing the call. 15-16. Tyler Ryder takes his seat. Fredonia on the kill.
And Rivera's back on the ice, so good news for Fredonia.
It's Malaforier down there. Walgren at the bottom of the blue line. Switches out with Orojo. Walgren at the blue line gives back. Walgren dishes to Orojo. A whistle is blown.
Looks like they're going to call Plattsburgh on a penalty.
DeFelice heading to the box.
Or Christian. Maybe not.
Alaforia? No, we're just penalty. Moving the faceoff out of the zone.
I don't know what that was all about.
Interesting play. Possibly something down at the net mouth.
Yeah, the ref was pointing at the net. Thought there was a penalty, but apparently not.
Going back and forth at the far boards. Fredonia will get the dump. Goes right in on Borieta. 3:50 to go here in the third period. Nearly a minute gone on the kill. The pass, a cross ice pass from Owens, knocked down and then cleared by the Blue Devils.
Forty-five seconds left in the penalty.
Holding up and waiting at his own net is Matt Arujo. Dishes to Sloan, who goes for a cross-ice pass. Barber. Plattsburgh and Fredonia stopped up at the top boards. Luke Rivera trying to move it forward. Middleton dishes it in on Bogart and makes the save.
So 18 seconds left on the penalty and 3:03 left in the game. So if Fredonia can kill off another penalty, they will be left with just under 2:40. Or actually, no, it'll be exactly 2 minutes and 45 seconds to try to tie this game up.
Off the draw, Fredonia makes the clear. That's Max Blitz dumping it all the way right again into the glove of Jimmy Borieta. Fredonia has possession. Josh Biasulo trying to make a dance to make something happen, but get tangled up, forced back towards neutral ice.
Back to even strength.
Back to 5-on-5 play for Fredonia and Plattsburgh. Again, Fredonia down only by one goal. Plattsburgh leads 3-2. Here's Todd Schaus with a chance, a shot in, out in front. Jacob Haynes had the net marked, but it gets lifted up. Shot out of play.
That was a really nice move from Schaus to get open. He fed Haynes, and Haynes' shot got deflected out of play, and just a really good opportunity for Fredonia. With 2:26 left in the third.
And we will be keeping an eye on Eric Bogart, because there is quite a good chance that he might go to the bench sometime soon.
Let's go Devils, the chant from the Steel Hall crowd at the top of the blue line. The Cardinals and Blue Devils get tangled all up. Here is Jacob Haynes trying to make something happen. Peel it off the boards. He'll try to do so. It's collected up and dumped all the way. As Fredonia's back to clear, to clean up. Here's Tommy Martin trying to make exit of the zone. Here goes Schaus again. Schaus, Hines, and Jimmy Morgan, a shot.
Bogart
there
is
goes Bogart.
Bogart to the bench. And that puck's going to tumble. It's going to go wide. Thankfully, whistled down as icing as Blitz wins the race.
Minute 47 left.
Yes, here is not the time for mistakes, ladies and gentlemen. They have to be on their game just in every aspect, defense, offense. And they really can't afford to leave the Plattsburgh zone here.
And we're going to have a timeout called now.
Timeout coming.
Probably the smartest call right now.
Plattsburgh crests 50 shots. Fredonia at 19. On the verge of cresting 20 here. Bogart making 47 saves. Which continues the strong effort from yesterday to keep his team as well in this race.
Well, you know, this will
32 saves made yesterday by Bogart.
And now we're going to see what Fredonia's made of. You know, they've been chipping away at this game the whole night. Now a minute 47 left. And Now everything's on the line now, so who's gonna come up big?
Victor Tracy came up big last night against the Bears, scoring a last-minute goal from on a slap shot. Then Fredonia got good blessings from a delayed offside in the final 15 seconds to have forced Plattsburgh to clear the zone, give Fredonia enough time to seal the deal. Slightly different story here as now Plattsburgh is up. Think back to the Buff State game. Fredonia was up by two. They let things slip away, but Fredonia here certainly ramping up the work ethic across three periods. Fredonia will look to advance the puck. Six men on the ice with the empty net for the Blue Devils. Trying to peel it off the board, losing control of it was Max Blitz at the blue line. Fredonia collects, they look to advance. Blitz makes the shot in, cross ice off the boards. Ethan Kirbis, Todd Schaus, all on the boards. Charlie Manley back to Blitz, back to Manley. A shot in, it goes wide. Fredonia collapses, final minute of the play. Trying to push the envelope, it's a bounce off escape. Kirbis to make it happen, Schaus out in front. They missed the shot, it goes up over the net.
Someone
tangled up behind the net. Possible skate malfunction, no.
And the net fell off.
It's off the moorings.
The pipes. But yeah, Schaus with a great opportunity, just shot it inches too high.
So a little time recap here. There's only 48.3 seconds left here to third. It is do or die for the Blue Devils.
Faceoff coming to the right of Paeta. Leaning in, Owens and Tommy Martin. Ryder wins that draw, and Fredonia has possession off. They collect it down at the bottom of the blue line, trying to prevent Plattsburgh from getting that forward. The last line of defense able to save that, but Plattsburgh has possession. Makes the long dump. Great stop from Max.
20 seconds
Max Blitz,
left.
Willing to put it forward. Jacob Haynes trying to pull it off the boards. Blitz keeps it from going offside. Manley with the shot in. It bounces up over the net. 10 seconds. 7 off the top of the boards. Plattsburgh, here's
a shot.
Blitz. The puck bounces out of side with a single second. Plattsburgh dumps to seal the deal on Pink the Rink night. Plattsburgh plays the spoiler. It's 3-2 for the Cardinals.
I have to say, good effort by Fredonia there in the last 2 minutes, but they can't fall behind that early in the game, allowing 30 shots in the first period and expect to like catch up. Like it is amazing that they were able to keep out like as many shots as they did, but it's just very, they need to ramp up their play over the next two games.
Yeah, I am still confused at how a team that's in sixth place right now, just 3 points out of third place, and a home playoff game can come out so flat on such a huge night with Pink the Rink, all the festivities here, and just like all the playoff implications, they were just very flat the first two periods. Yes, they did pick it up in the third, but I mean, that's definitely something they need to work on here with two games left and then the playoffs.
Do you have thoughts to share, Chris? Is that fair? All right. yes, that was a game where I think certainly Fredonia was willing. Fredonia, again, showing that they could very well put in the work. But unfortunately, things just got too far away from them, especially when it came to on-ice tempo, shot counts. 50-19, the final. Just a mind-blowing number. Where Plattsburgh seemed not even willing to skip a single beat coming down from Buff State. as they roll out the pink carpet here. Post-game ceremonies on Pink the Rink night as jersey presentations happen. Jimmy Morgan, the player of the game, had Fredonia's first goal in the second period on an excellent breakout pass from Ethan Kirbus.
And now, you know, just looking at the standings here, it's just very disappointing for Fredonia with, you know, a loss starting with January 18th to Geneseo. Two ties against Brockport and Buff State, games in which they were up and then let the opposing team come back and tie it up. And then three consecutive losses to Buff State, Oswego, and Cortland. And now they find themselves in sixth place. So they could have easily been in third right now. But
an interesting tale of two halves of the season where a great 2018 folds, turns the calendar into a mediocre 2019. You look at it in just plain black and white. Fredonia let something really nice here slip away. And granted, yes, they are thankfully still in the playoffs. But the situation is vastly different than how they used to be. Back towards the end of the last semester up in Canton.
So once again, Plattsburgh musters up 50 shots on net. Fredonia just 19. And Eric Bogart, 47 saves. And then for Fredonia, Jimmy Morgan. Okay, yeah, Morgan had both goals.
The whole program here for Pink the Rink Night. It's an impressive thing. But Pink the Rink Night is a yearly event, of course. Benefits the American Cancer Society. Eric Bogart wears a jersey in honor of his grandparents, Patricia Gonzer and Ronald Bogart. Patricia is a breast cancer survivor, graduate of University of Michigan.
And once again, this is the 13th year of doing Pink the Rink. It began as a class project in 2007 to promote breast cancer awareness. And Coach Meredith just announced that in the 13 years, they've raised over $90,000.
Chandler Judd, number two, wearing a jersey as a tribute to Vermel Reeves. His mother.
Accepting the number three, Abe Davis jersey in honor of
Matt Lemansky, wearing a jersey in honor of former Fredonia State student Alfred Alexander Davis. Known to his friends as Cheese, diagnosed in October 2008 with colorectal cancer. John Carlson wearing a jersey in honor of John Michael Lasher, the younger brother of Lori Tamatra, adjunct member of the Voice Facility and brother-in-law to Daniel M. Dramatra, Associate Vice President for Enrollment Services here on the Fredonia campus. John diagnosed brain cancer in 2009, undergone three cranorectomies, radiation, and multiple courses of chemotherapy. Charlie Manley, number five, wears a jersey in honor of Mary Ellen Connor. Mary Ellen Connor Hart and Gerald Charles Hart. Manley chooses a poem to represent his comments on the jersey. Next in line will be Jacob Haynes, wearing a jersey in honor of Shelley Fitzgerald of Gates, New York, diagnosed with breast cancer into August 2016. Underwent a double mastectomy and chemo treatments late 16 and early 17. Is declared cancer-free. However, regressed in October 2018. To continue to live on. Thankfully. Wearing number 15, Max Blitz. A jersey in honor of Shane Noviello. Shane Noviello has been a hockey player since the age of six, learned to skate in Rochester, Minnesota, and didn't come off the ice until he was diagnosed with leukemia in May of 2017.
Accepting number 16,
he lives on to this day with a good prognosis. Ryan Dunn. Number 16 wears a jersey in honor of Tyus A. Howard. Diagnosed with breast cancer in 97. Continues to live to this day, thankfully.
Accepting the number 18, Delta Phi Epsilon jersey.
In honor of all brothers and sisters and their loved ones intentionally that have been affected by cancer, Ethan Kirbis wears number 18 for Delta Phi Epsilon. In honor of all brothers and sisters worldwide experiences with breast cancer. Victor Tracy will be wearing a jersey. Ella's down there. Ella's here, Ella Beach. Beginning chemotherapy on February 17th, 2018. Here in the building today, we started beginning to receive a standing ovation. Suffers for acute lymphomic leukemia, the most common form of cancer in children. Accompanied by her many friends from the Roswell Park Institute. Up in Buffalo, Ella's angels have made this journey possible. Through the darkness and the pain, there is always prayers and light that give her and her family hope.
Accepting the number 20 Dempsey jersey in honor.
Mike Freeman wears Mike Freeman wearing number 20 in honor of Kathleen M. Dempsey, resident of Bolivar, New York, for 61 years graduate, Bolivar Central High School, Brast College, Sacred Heart, Lake Forest, Illinois. A mother of 8 children. A substitute in the area public schools when time was available. Take a second photo there. Bobby Polichuk will be wearing a jersey in honor of Julie Gaius, Julie Gallus. Bridget Gallus's mom lives in North Tonawanda, New York. Julie is a mother of 4. Julie was diagnosed with stage 1 breast cancer in 2017 at the age of 44. Julie is a survivor. 26 sessions of chemotherapy. Julie is now doing well, strong woman who never gave up and kept fighting. Julie participates in Ride for Roswell each year and continues to get people to join her. Audrey Almquist is the name on the jersey of Jimmy Morgan.
Along with Terry and Debbie Patterson from their son,
live for
Jimmy
her.
Morgan, one of our captains.
The mother of Jimmy Morgan, amazing baker, and homemade donuts were always in high demand. A hockey fan, Minnesota North Stars fan, watched their games in her kitchen on a 12-inch black and white TV. Lives carrying the legacy of love, carrying 11 children, 20 grandchildren, and 14 great-grandkids. Luke Rivera, number 23, is wearing a jersey in honor of Carol Booth, who unfortunately lost her battle with cancer on Friday, August 10th, 2018. A horrific case of leukemia. In honor of Albano family members that have been under the experience of cancer. Peter and Bob Albano, out of Welland, Ontario, graduates of Oswego State.
Accepting the number 25 Martelli jersey.
Phil Martelli is the name on the jersey of Brendan Spagnardi. Phil has continued a healthy attitude towards his life of golf, staying fit. He's alive today, but however not able to attend the event.
The number 26 Sigma Kappa jersey.
Colin Valentine.
In
honor of former Fredonia State student Jessa Weber. Suffered a 7-year battle with brain cancer. Sigma Kappa values personal growth, friendship, service, and loyalty, all bounded by a promise. Colin Valentine wears the name Sigma Kappa on his jersey.
Accepting the number 27, Jessa's Quest jersey, in honor of Jessa Weber, his
The final jersey tonight. No, not the final tonight jersey tonight, but number 27 by Thomas Martin, Tommy Martin. Jessa Weber is the name on the jersey. Jessa's Quest, nonprofit organization formed by friends and family of Jessa Weber to raise money for organizations dedicated to the care and nurturing of children with cancer. Since founded, Jessa's Quest has donated over $135,000 to OCI Children's Hospital, local organizations that support them. Marnie Rakow is the name on Josh Biasulo's jersey. Morgan Markow's mom lives in Rhinebeck, New York. She's been married for close to 22 years as a mother to two brilliant daughters. Diagnosed with breast cancer in October of 2017, finished chemo and radiation treatments in November 2018. Ryan Rosenberg delivers the jersey for Brent in honor of Brenda Hennessy, mother of two, graduate of three, grandmother of three, aunt of 10, currently residing in Fredonia. Bright diagnosed with breast cancer of April 2018, currently cancer-free following surgery, radiation for June to September of 2018. A long list of incredible people, inspiring stories. Brings Pink the Rink.
Last I talked to you, you said you weren't coming out of the ice, but I'm happy to fire this up here.
Looks like we have one last.
Our last jersey, the DeMarco jersey.
The DeMarco jersey, simply in honor of awareness, supporting breast cancer awareness.
Thank you.
A simple gesture, actually. And with that ends the Pink the Rink ceremony. A bittersweet end to a game, but a fairly long one. We've had you on the air here for long enough. I think it's just fair enough that if we say our goodbyes here as a yikes. Sounds like I'm signing off the air for the last time.
That is correct here.
Oh boy.
Both of you guys are.
Oh.
So thanks for all you've done over the years.
Lord.
We're going to miss you next year.
Yeah, well, ladies and gentlemen, listeners of WCVF 889 The Voice, it's been an incredible time. I've been here to bring you your Fredonia Blue Devils as the play-by-play voice. Kevin, you stepped in me for one time. I had to take a trip to Brooks. I will